Hello class. In this video, I just want to discuss a little bit about the evolution of the Australopithecines. We know Australopithecines were around between 4 and 1 million years ago. The earliest Australopithecines, represented here by Australopithecus afarensis, Lucy's species, were around between roughly 4 and 3 million years ago. And just a few of the features of Australopithecus, very ape-like, very chimpanzee-like. Couple aspects of the skull is really the only thing that's different from chimpanzees is they don't have as robust front teeth, they don't have a sagittal crest, they don't have as much prognathism. The front teeth are a little smaller, but still quite a bit bigger than humans, and they are clearly bipeds based on the position of the foramen and magnum, the shape of their pelvis, and such. So these guys are around walking about in eastern Africa for maybe 500,000 to a million years. Then somewhere around 3 million years ago, we get speciation occurring, where we end up with two different manifestations. And so in the first, we've already talked about the genus Paranthropus, here represented by Paranthropus boisei. These were Australopithecines that likely evolved from a species like Lucy, but had special adaptations particular to their diet. So features about their skull that were related to diet, but still very similar, still fit within the Australopithecines, small-brained, bipedal animals. Over here we have the later Australopithecine species, often referred to as the gracile Australopithecine. And these guys, if you take a look, this is Australopithecus africanus. This is actually a specimen referred to as Ms. Ples, found in a cave in southern Africa. And you can see that these features are not nearly as robust as the Paranthropus species, nor are they as robust as the Australopithecus afarensis species. You've got a much smaller brow ridge. The zygomatic arches are still pretty wide, but not like that of either afarensis or the Paranthropus, certainly not like the Paranthropus. There's no sagittal crest. And a big thing is, take a look at the dental arcade. Now, there's no teeth in this dental arcade, but you can see the teeth, if they were here, would be much more proportional. The front of the mouth and the back of the mouth are more proportional to each other than you can see in the Australopithecus afarensis, where you have the still big teeth in the front, not quite like a chimp's, but still very big teeth in the front, and in this case, more proportional. The actual set of teeth that Australopithecus africanus has is pretty similar to humans. It's larger, but it's more proportional like humans. Less prognathism. So overall, this skull is less robust than either of these two. And that's why we refer to it as the gracile Australopithecines. That's all I want.